What is up, fellow nerds, and welcome back to the Dapper Snapper Gaming Channel, and welcome back to How Do I Want to Do This? This is our series where we take every class and subclass and look at them from a power standpoint and rank them on a scale of 1 to 10. Keep in mind that this has nothing to do with the role-playing aspect of the character. This is simply mechanical for the purposes of combat exploration and just the ability to work in social interactions as well as combat, so all of those things are what we are looking for, and the role playing, you could be good at role playing pretty much anything in here, so I don't think that that's really a factor that we're going to be considering here. Now today we're going to be covering the Armorer Artificer, and this is something I've been looking forward to for a little while. This is a really fun subclass, allows you to basically have a awesome decked out suit of armor, and so we're gonna see just how good that is. But before we do, make sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe if you haven't already. The vast majority of the viewers of these videos are not subscribed, so please make sure that you are not one of those people and go ahead and subscribe, and that way you don't miss any of our future episodes. Later this week we will be putting out a build guide for the Armorer, and that will be a lot of fun. Last week we did the Alchemist and we did it all in one video and it ended up being like an hour long, so we're gonna split that into two videos this week just for just so that it's not so much at one time, so that way it'll be a little bit more of an enjoyable viewing experience for you. But again, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, share with your friends, and down in the comments below, help us beat the YouTube algorithm and let me know what you would have on your very own decked out magical or just very technologically advanced suit of armor. I'd love to know, so hit me up down below. So let's talk briefly about what the Armorer is. So this is the artificer that actually uses a suit of armor to channel the powers that he or she possesses. So instead of using tools, instead of using wands and that sort of thing, this character will use the armor to channel the powers. And so it's really, really neat being able to have that Iron Man-esque feel to it and being able to use armor as an offensive weapon as well as a defensive buff. So it's really, really cool being able to use your best defense as your best offense. And so it's really, really cool as far as that goes. Now, interesting thing about this one is that this was actually not released alongside the other three subclasses in Eberron Rising from the Last War. This was only released in Tasha's Cauldron of Everything. So this one is a little bit unique in that it was released later. It had an Unearthed Arcana that was out for a little while before going into Tasha's, and it's really, really neat. So let's go ahead and talk about what all this thing gets. So at third level, we're actually going to get four abilities rather than three, which is awesome. First, we get Tools of the Trade. Of course, we get our tool proficiencies here. We get Smith's Tools, so the ability to work on your armor, which is really neat. We also, though, get Heavy Armor proficiency. This changes things. This definitely takes just a normal tool proficiency that everybody else gets from what I rated a 4 in my last video. This is going to drastically change it because now we have the ability to use heavy armor, and we're definitely going to do that on any build of the Armorer because our entire ability kind of revolves around it. So we're gonna have a naturally very high AC because we're taking the suit of armor, the suit of heavy armor, and it's gonna be absolutely amazing. So the ability to now use heavy armor on the artificer, and you'll see why this is so important later, we're gonna change this from what would be a 4 to a 9 out of 10. This is incredibly impactful as we move on. Second thing we get at third level is the expanded spell list. And so some standout options on this spell list are, well, all of them. Every spell on this list is good and worth taking, and if I had to choose amongst spells and these were on the list, I would choose these. But that's just it. We don't have to choose any of these, we just get them. So some standouts here are obviously Greater Invisibility, Hypnotic Pattern, which doesn't make sense to me on how you get it, but I'm not gonna complain. We get Wall of Force, which is one of the best spells just in the game, flat out of any type. We also get Pass Wall, which is a spell that I normally don't pick up even when I can take it. It's one of those spells that nobody really ever takes, but then you're kicking yourself for not taking it when you need it because it can be super important. So just having it straight up is really, really nice. Magic Missile and Thunder Wave early on are really, really great to have on this. There's not a single spell on here that I don't like. This is a 10 out of 10 expanded spell list. It's absolutely awesome. Also at third level, we get Arcane Armor, and this is what allows us to make our armor magical, and it gives us three really interesting benefits. So the first one is that we now get to ignore the strength requirement of armor. So this is cool for heavy armor, which we're definitely gonna want on this. Normally there are strength requirements on heavy armor, and so this will ignore that. We can use the armor as our arcane focus, which we'll get back to in just a second, and it can't be removed against our will and also replaces missing limbs. So the strength requirement is really interesting to be able to ignore because as an artificer, we typically aren't using strength. Strength is normally a dump stat unless you're going for a melee fighter. But at the same time, if you're wanting to do a melee fighter, you may look at another subclass, which we will talk about here in a little bit. Not in this video, but later on in the series. Otherwise, you're probably not going to want your strength to be all that crazy. And even on that subclass that we're talking about, you don't even need your strength to be all that high anyway because you get to use your intelligence. So yeah, you really usually are dumping strength in this build. And so yeah, being able to ignore that is really, really awesome. The being able to use this as your arcane focus is cool and very much is made much more important by the fourth ability we get, which we will talk about when we talk about that. And then the rest of it is kind of flavorful. So, you know, if you've lost an arm, then you can replace it with the armor, which is cool. Lost a leg, same thing. It'll cover for that. So that's pretty cool as far as flavor goes. There's no mechanical advantage there, but it's pretty neat. It's pretty neat. So I'm gonna give this a solid 8 out of 10. It gets a little bit better when we look at how it combines with the next power. And so it's cool. It's a really cool power. Obviously it fuels everything that we're doing. And so let's see just how well it gels with this last power we get at level 3. So finally at third level, we get armor model. And what this does is it allows you to choose between the guardian or infiltrator model of armor, and you can switch these out on a short or long rest. So you can choose between all the buffs we're gonna already talk about on a short rest. You can switch it up anytime you want. You're not locked in. Say at level 3, you have to make the choice. No, it is every short rest or long rest you can choose. So if you know you're about to go into a dungeon and you wanna be super sneaky, take a short rest. Switch it up and you're good to go. If you are going in loud and proud and you just want to be tanky, you can go guardian and you're good to go. So it's really, really cool having that flexibility that already raises the stock for this, but let's see what else they give you. The guardian starts out by giving you a melee attack that does thunder damage. And when you hit a creature with this attack, it actually gives them disadvantage on every creature except for you. This is incredibly useful just because you are going to be the one with the highest AC most likely, just because you have both infusions at this time and you have heavy armor. So if you've gotten the heaviest armor that you can possibly find, you probably have the highest AC in the party. And the opponent has disadvantage on every single attack it goes for if it's not on you, and it's probably going to miss you. So yeah, you're putting yourself in a really good position by using this. You also can just give yourself temporary HP as a bonus action for free. It's there. You get to use it a number of times per day, but it's still pretty awesome. So yeah, Guardian's pretty good. So what does Infiltrator do? Infiltrator actually allows us to be a little bit more sneaky. And this can be really, really helpful as well. So our attack is actually a ranged attack that you can use either by shooting the gauntlets off of your fist or by just using a chest piece. So kind of like Iron Man shooting the chest mounted weapon, which is pretty cool. And you also get an increased walking speed and advantage on stealth checks while wearing the armor. So this is there to negate the disadvantage that you would normally get from wearing heavy armor. Now, one thing to keep in mind with the wording is that this does not allow you to ever have advantage or disadvantage on stealth. It does not remove the disadvantage. It simply gives you advantage for the sake of equaling them out. Now in Dungeons & Dragons, you can't have super advantage. You can't have, well, let's say you have two ways of getting advantage and you have one way of getting disadvantage. You don't get advantage in that way. You are just a straight roll. Any amount on either side is just a straight roll. So you will always be straight rolling for stealth. Now this is not a disadvantage, so that's definitely a huge buff, but just keep that in mind. You will never have advantage or disadvantage on this. So even if, say, you have a trickery domain cleric in your party, gives you blessing of the trickster, doesn't help. So you are always going to be rolling straight on these, but better than disadvantage. So you also get the attacks, which are cool, and that uses your intelligence modifier, which makes them that much more useful because you're pumping up your intelligence by now. And by next level, you can probably take an ability score improvement to get yourself up to 20 if you're at 19, or maybe switch it up and do something else, maybe take a feat. It's pretty interesting. The ranged attack actually does work with something like sharpshooter. So that's also cool. And these also get a buff at level 15. Each of the models actually get an extra feature at level 15, which we will talk about later. But so there's a little bit of like comboing here and it all works pretty well. I've got to give this a 10 out of 10. Like, giving yourself an extra attack that uses intelligence is awesome. And the extra features on both sides, and you can switch it out on a shorter long rest. There's no bad thing here. Not a single thing here is bad, and it's all very, very helpful. This is a 10 out of 10, easy. At level 5, we get extra attack. What's better than one attack? Two attacks, so now you can attack twice. And yes, this does apply to the gauntlet attacks too, so that's awesome. I'm just gonna give extra attacks 10 out of 10 on every single thing that gets extra attack. It's just always good. It's always better to be attacking twice. So at level 9, we get armor modifications. And so this allows us to actually split up our armor for the sake of our infusions. Now this is a very interesting power because it actually allows us to split up our armor into the chest piece, the boots, the helmet, and either the gauntlets or chest mounted weapon, whichever one you're using depending on the model. Now this is cool because you actually also get two extra infusions. You can infuse two more items than what you normally would be able to, and they have to apply to your armor. So basically you can just be a Christmas tree now and have your entire body covered in magical items. And so you can have magical weapon you're holding in your hand, magical gauntlets or chest piece, magical helm or helmet, magical boots. Like, you can just be covered in all kinds of magical items, and they all are giving you these amazing buffs. Like I said, we're going to be doing an entire video on the infusions later, and yeah, some of the options that we can have here are absolutely insane. We'll go into more depth of those when we do our build guide later this week, so again, make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss that. But yeah, this gives you so many more things that you can do. Plus, it also combos in with the level 20 ability, which allows you to get back up with 0 HP by ending an infusion. You have two more than any other subclass. So instead of going down 6 times and getting back up, you can go down and get back up 8 times if you end infusions. This is insane. This is a 10 out of 10. No questions asked. It's awesome. Finally, at level 15, we have perfected armor. And so this allows you to actually have new ways to use both the infiltrator and the guardian armor. So what do you get? The guardian actually gets a new way of getting people into melee with itself, which combos right into your gauntlets. So if a creature that you can see ends its turn within 30 feet of you, you can force it to make a strength save or pull it within 5 feet of you. Then just punch it in the face immediately with your gauntlet if you want to. It can be any melee weapon, but usually it's probably going to want to be your gauntlet. The reason is because you're now giving it disadvantage on any attack against somebody other than you, except now it's in your face. And so now you're going to be the one punching it and it's going to want to get out of there. but it's kind of stuck because then you'll just get an attack of opportunity. If it tries to attack you, you've got an AC that's through the roof. It creates all kinds of problems for the enemies. So let's see if the infiltrator is any better. We get some interesting abilities here. So the infiltrator now, when you hit a target with your either gauntlet or chest mounted attack, you give disadvantage to any attacks against you. So that's cool. Also, the next attack roll against it has advantage and deals a little bit of extra damage. So that's pretty cool as well. I don't think that this is as useful as the Guardian one. And Guardian, it only being 30 feet is a little bit limited. However, you're gonna be the frontliner. So 30 feet usually probably isn't gonna be that big of a deal. You can use your movement and then get to wherever you need to go, pull the enemy close to you, and then just punch them in the face. So you've got some pretty cool stuff going on here. You've basically got a 30-foot aura going on of death and destruction that you've got if you've got the Guardian armor going on, and it can definitely save your squishier party members. So what I see here is someone in melee combat with, say, your wizard, that your wizard doesn't want to be in melee combat, and you're just like, nope, I'm gonna just save you, and pull it back over to you, and you just start going to town on it, and it can't leave, or else it takes an attack of opportunity. If it tries to attack the wizard again, it has disadvantage. It's just all kinds of problems for the enemy. So it's really, really, really good. I really, really like all of this. And again, all of these are switched out on a short or long rest. All kinds of versatility. It's awesome. I'm gonna give this an 8 out of 10. I don't think it's quite worth the 10. I think that it could be better. I think that we could, if we could use extra attack on it, it would be super good. That would definitely push Guardian over the edge here. And I feel like it's a little tame on the infiltrator side. I feel like they could do a little bit more with it, but it's still very strong. So I'm still gonna stick with an 8. So that's it. That's your subclass. That is what the armorer gets. And I really don't think that it's gonna come as a shock to anyone when I give this a 10 out of 10. This is by far the best subclass available to Artificers. This thing is strong and it gets a lot done. So first of all, you're gonna have a really high AC. It's just what you're doing. You know, the entire point of you is to have heavy armor and to just go crazy with it and use its abilities to attack and defend. It allows you to have the gauntlet attacks, which are awesome, but it allows you to basically use somatic components without needing to hold anything because you've got your arcane focus as your armor, which is cool. So you can just be holding a shield and that's it. And so you're good to go. You just hold a shield and you can do your somatic components in your other hand and you're good. You're totally set to do whatever you want to do. If you want to carry a weapon, great. If you don't want to, you really don't have to. The shield is there just to give your AC a little bit of a boost, even more than it already was. And then you've got all your infusions that we haven't even talked about yet. Your infusions just take this even more over the top, and getting two extras that have to be used on you. So now you can have boots of flying. Now you can have enhanced armor. You can have enhanced weapon, a helm of awareness, like all of these super busted ones, you can have all going on you at once. You can just be a little Christmas tree, and you're actually not being nearly as selfish because two of them have to be on you. So it's awesome. It's so nice. This is the best subclass that you've got in there. And I'm honestly excited to see if they can top this in later books, if they make any more subclasses for the Artificer. I'm interested to see if they can beat this, to see if they can make anything more busted, because I feel like it's gonna be pretty tough. So yeah, that's all I got for today for you. So later this week, we're gonna be doing a build guide. And so we're going to be actually building an armorer together. And that is going to be a lot of fun. So make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss that. Ring the bell so that you are notified whenever that goes live. And yeah, besides that, make sure you've already liked the video, all of those good things. So I hope that you guys have a great day, a great week, all of these things. I will see you later this week. Have a good one. Bye-bye.